Thank you. Here begins the 15th verse of the 37th chapter of the prophecy of Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, take a stick and write on it, for Judah and the children of Israel associated with me. Then take another stick and write upon it, for Joseph, the stick of Ephraim, and all the house of Israel associated with him. And join them together into one stick, that they may become one in your hand. And when your people say to you, will you not show us what you mean by these? Say to them, thus says the Lord God, behold, I am about to take the stick of Joseph, which is in the hand of Ephraim, and the tribes of Israel associated with him. And I will join it with the stick of Judah, and make them one stick, that they may be one in my hand. When the sticks on which you write are in your hand before their eyes, then say to them, thus says the Lord God, behold, I will take the people of Israel from the nations among which they have gone, and will gather them from all sides, and bring them to their own land. And I will make them one nation in a land, upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king over them all. And they shall be no longer two nations, and no longer divided into two kingdoms. They shall not defile themselves any more with idols and their detestable things, or with any of their transgressions. But I will save them from all the backslidings in which they have sinned, and will cleanse them, and they shall be my people, and I will be their God. My servant David shall be king over them, and they shall all have one shepherd. They shall follow my ordinances and be careful to observe my statutes. They shall dwell in a land where your fathers dwelt that I gave to my servant Jacob. They and their children's children shall dwell there forever. And David my servant shall be their prince forever. I will make a covenant of peace with them. It shall be an everlasting covenant with them, and I will bless them and multiply them, and will set my sanctuary in the midst of them forevermore. My dwelling place shall be with them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Then the nations will know that I, the Lord, sanctify Israel, when my sanctuary is in the midst of them forevermore. It ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
Gospel according to St. Mark. Now, after John was arrested, Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the Gospel of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the Gospel." And passing along by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, the brother of Simon, casting a net in the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you become fishers of men." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And going on a little farther, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, who were in their boat mending the nets. And immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired servants and followed him. Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you. such things as be life, but we, who cannot do anything that is good without thee, may by thee be enabled to live according to thy will, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be said to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. And by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
This cathedral church also stood at the heart of a Benedictine monastery. As a reminder of that inheritance, it is our custom to read from the rule of St. Benedict at this service. But this reading also provides us with spiritual wisdom for our life in community today. Reading from chapter 4 of the rule, on the tools for good works, that is, the spiritual disciplines that can help fashion us as followers of Jesus Christ. To fulfill God's commandments daily in one's deeds, to love chastity, to hate no one, not to be jealous, not to harbour envy, not to love contention, to beware of haughtiness, to respect the seniors, to love the juniors, to pray for one's enemies in the love of Christ, to make peace with one's adversary before the sun sets, and never to despair of God's mercy. These then are the tools of the spiritual craft. Let us pray. The prayer of St. Benedict. Gracious and Holy Father, give us wisdom to know you, diligence to seek you, patience to wait for you, eyes to perceive you, a heart to meditate upon you, and a life to proclaim you, by the power of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We pray for the life and witness of God's Church, for Justin, our Archbishop, and Graham, our Bishop, for Ian, Bishop of Thetford, and Jane, Bishop of Lynn, and for all the parishes, schools, and chaplaincies of this Diocese of Norwich. Especially today for the parish of Gaywood, for Kyla Sorensen, the parish priest, for Daphne Sampson, the licensed lay minister, and for the congregations and communities that they serve. We also give thanks for the life of this cathedral church, praying for all who have shared in its life today, and remembering with thanksgiving those who have witnessed and ministered here in centuries past and have now entered into their eternal rest. Among them are de Lesmere, monk here in 1283, Richard de Wicklewood, monk here in 1325, and also Lancelot Fleming, Bishop of Norwich, who died on this day in 1919. Eternal Father, who art not the God of the dead but of the living, we give thee thanks and praise for all the generations of the faithful, who, having served thee here in godliness and love, are now with thee in paradise. And we beseech thee, enable us so to follow them in all godly living and faithful service, that hereafter we may with them behold thy face, and in their heavenly places be one with them forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today the Church gives thanks for William Wilberforce, Lauda Appiano, and Thomas Clarkson, who with Thomas Buxton, who we also commemorate in this cathedral, were pioneers in the campaign against slavery and the slave trade. As we remember their witness, so we pray for all those who campaign for social justice today, those who are the victims of modern slavery, and those working for their freedom. so we may bring compassion to all and work for the freedom of all the children of God. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And let us pray for all those who are in pain and distress this night. All those who are victims of violence and abuse. Continuing to pray for the community in Southport following the attacks yesterday. We pray for those who have died and those who are injured. For families and friends are all seeking to bring comfort in the midst of trauma. God of all comfort, in the midst of pain, heal us with your love. In the darkness of sorrow, shine upon us as the morning star. Awaken in us the spirit of mercy, that as we feel the pain of others, we may share with them the comfort we receive from you. And bring us at the last with all your people into the kingdom of your glory, where death itself is ended, and every tear is wiped from every eye. This we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We commend ourselves and all for whom we pray this night to the love and mercy of God, as we say together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of be with us all, evermore. Amen.
The Lord.